Shalom. First and foremost, I want to give all praises, honor, and infinite glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rukah Kodash. For giving me the spirit to do this lesson, Yahweh, being the name of the Heavenly Father, Bahashem, meaning the name of Yahweh Shai, being the name of Yahweh's only begotten Son and our Lord and Savior, also who the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ. Bahashem Rukah Kodash, meaning in the name of the Holy Spirit. Double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone, and Shalom to the hopeful elect that scatter abroad to the four corners of the earth, which are you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Native American Indians, and Shalom to you speckled birds, and you Israelite foreigners that scatter out in other nations that look like the other nations, but are in fact Israelites. And I'm not sure, you know, what I'm gonna title this lesson just yet, you know, but in this lesson, you know, I'm going to be going into the account, you know, of our forefather Jacob, all right, which is the progenitor of the 12 tribes of Israel, all right. I'm going to be going into the account, you know, where Jacob wrestled against an angel, all right, you know, because, you know, he wanted a blessing, all right. And when you read the that account, you know, the angel of the Lord, you know, he couldn't prevail against Jacob. All right, because Jacob, he was pretty much winning and whatnot. And the angel, you know, told Jacob to stop. And Jacob, he refused to fight unless that angel had, you know, gave him a blessing. All right. So, you know, because of that, you know, the angel, you know, made Jacob's thigh come out of his joint and whatnot. All right. Come out of his socket. And, you know, despite, you know, the angel doing that, you know, Jacob continued to wrestle. All right. So, you know, I want to do a quick lesson, you know, dealing with this account, because it's a very valuable lesson that we could all, you know, learn from this. All right. You know, because, you know, as, you know, brothers always say in their lessons, you know, when you come into this truth, you know, you're going to have to fight. All right. You know, if we want that blessing, the same way that, you know, Jacob had to fight for his blessing and whatnot, you know. So in our time, you know, in our day to day life, you know, we're going to have to fight. All right. And during this fight, you know, there's going to be certain things that's thrown in our way. All right. You know, our thigh might be taken out of his socket, so to speak, you know, because that's ultimately what happened to Jacob. All right. But I'm not talking about literally for us. You know, when I say our thigh might be taken out of our socket, you know, I'm saying like certain things might happen in our life, you know, to try to throw us off, you know. But, you know, despite that happening, you know, our desire for that blessing, you know, must, you know, out, you know, overpower that. All right. You know, the struggles that we got to deal with, you know, the trials and tribulations, our desire for the kingdom, you know, and that blessing, you know, has to outweigh that. All right. The same way that Jacob's desire for that blessing, you know, outweighed, you know, the pain from, you know, his thigh being taken out of his socket. All right. So, you know, through the spirit, you know, this is going to be a quick exhortation for you brothers and you sisters out there, you know, to keep fighting, all right? Keep fighting for that blessing, which is ultimately, you know, the kingdom of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, eternal life, living forever, all right? So without further ado, let's go ahead and start with Genesis chapter 32. And let's start at verse 22. And it says, and he rose up that night and took his two wives and his two women servants and his 11 sons and passed over the ford Jacob. Verse 23, and it says he took them and sent them over the brook and sent over that he had. Verse 24, and Jacob was left alone, and there wrestled a man with him until the breaking of the day. All right, so this man, you know, is ultimately an angel. All right, Jacob began to wrestle with an angel, you know, until the breaking of a day. All right. So Jacob, he was wrestling with this angel for quite some time. All right. Let's continue. And it says, and when he saw that he prevailed not against him, he touched the hollow of his thigh. And the hollow of Jacob's thigh was out of joint as he wrestled with him. All right. So the angel saw that, you know, he couldn't prevail against Jacob. All right. Which shows how, you know, mighty Jacob was. Right. You know, Jacob had, you know, that type of strength. All right. He was a warrior. He was very mighty. All right. You know, because he was overpowering an angel of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. All right. But let's continue. And it says, and when he saw that he prevailed not against him, he touched the hollow of his thigh. and the hollow of Jacob's thigh was out of joint as he wrestled with him. All right, so the angel caused, you know, Jacob's thigh to come out of joint. All right, so let's continue. Let's see what happens. And it says, and he said, let me go, for the day breaketh. And he said, I will not let thee go except thou bless me. All right, so as you see, you know, the angel causing Jacob's thigh to come out of joint, it didn't even faze him. Why? Because his desire, you know, for that blessing, you know, overpowered that. All right, it outweighed that. All right, you know, so like I said, you know, this account, you know, could apply to our lives. All right, you know, and not in a literal, you know, aspect, you know, but more so in a spiritual aspect. You know, you know, in this walk of ours, you know, we're gonna have to fight, you know, we're gonna have to wrestle, so to speak, you know, and during this fight, you know, our thigh might get taken out of joint, you know, so to speak. All right, you know, different things might be thrown our way, you know, to cause us to trip up, you know, to fall, so on and so forth, you know, but we got to continue to fight. All right, our desire for the blessing, you know, the kingdom of Yahweh Shem Yahushai, eternal life, you know, has to outweigh, you know, the pain and suffering that we're dealing with on this side. All right, you know, the scriptures tell you in I believe Second Esdras, you know, chapter 7, you know, it talks about, you know, the condition of the battle, that he which is born must fight. All right, so just roughly paraphrasing, I'm gonna get that later on, you know. So like I said, you know, your desire, you know, for salvation, you know, that blessing, eternal life, the kingdom of Yahweh Shem Yahushai, it has to outweigh, you know, the pain and suffering and the trials and tribulations that we're dealing with right now. All right, the same way with Jacob, you know, his desire for that blessing outweighed the pain of his thigh being taken out of joint, you know, because as you see, he did not complain about it. He continued to wrestle. All right, but let's continue. Let's read verse 25 again. And it says, and when he saw that he prevailed not against him, he touched the hollow of his thigh, and the hollow of Jacob's thigh was out of joint as he wrestled with him. All right, verse 26, and he said, let me go, for the day breaketh. And he said, I will not let thee go except thou bless me. All right, so Jacob, he was determined to get that blessing. Verse 27, and it says, and he said unto him, what is thy name? And he said, Jacob. Verse 28, and he said, thy name shall be called no more Jacob, but Israel, all right, which is in the Hebrew Yasharallah, all right? For as a prince hast thou power with Yahweh and with men, and has prevailed, all right? So that's what ultimately Israel, Yasharallah, means, all right? Prince of the power, all right? You know, and ultimately that's what we are, all right? We're princes of the power. Hence why, you know, we're called sons of God, all right? Sons of the power, sons of Yahweh, sons of Yahweh, all right? You know, so let's continue. It says, verse 29, and it says, and Jacob asked him and said, tell me, I pray thee, thy name. And he said, wherefore is it that thou dost ask after my name? And he blessed him there, all right? You know, so because, you know, of this wrestle against this angel, you know, and Jacob, and the angel was not able to prevail against him, you know, Jacob's name was changed to Israel, all right? You know, which means prince of the power, all right? Let's continue, verse 31, and it says, and as he passed over Peniel, the sun rose up upon him, Salaki rose upon him, and he halted upon his thigh. Verse 32, therefore the children of Israel eat not of the sinew which shrank, which is upon the hollow of the thigh, unto this day, because he touched the hollow of Jacob's thigh and the sinew that shrank. All right, so, you know, this is a very, you know, beautiful, you know, account right here, right? Because like I said, you know, this is, you know, very spiritual, and it can apply to our life, right? You know, because just like Jacob, you know, he was fighting for that blessing, you know, despite his thigh being taken out of joint. You know, it's the same way, you know, for us, all right? You know, in this walk of ours, you know, we have to fight, all right? And we have to continue to fight despite, you know, whatever trials and tribulations is thrown our way, all right? You know, like Jacob, his thigh was taken out of joint, you know, in the spiritual aspect, you know, our thigh might be taken out of joint, all right? Different things might happen to us, but our desire for the kingdom has to outweigh that, all right? You know? So from here, I want to get 1 Timothy chapter 6. and verse 12. And it says, fight the good fight of faith, lay hold on eternal life, whereunto thou art also called and has professed a good profession before many witnesses. All right, so you know, this is what we're ultimately supposed to be doing, fighting a good fight of faith. All right, you know, because that's the only way that you're going to be able to prevail, you know, through the different trials and tribulations that's thrown in our path. All right, you know, during this fight, you know, it's through faith, you know, and through that, you know, fighting a good fight of faith, that's going to lead us to eternal life. All right, that's why it says fight the good fight of faith, lay hold on eternal life, because you know, if we continue to fight and endure, that's exactly what we're going to get. That blessing is eternal life, living forever. All right, the kingdom Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. All right, so hey, the same way that Jacob wrestled, you know, he fought despite, you know, his thigh being taken out of joint, we got to do the same. All right, so let's get Second Esdras chapter 7, and let's start at verse 57. And it says, then answered he me and said, this is the condition of the battle which man that is born upon the earth shall fight. All right, so hey, this is a fight that we're in right now. All right, same way that our forefather Jacob, he had to wrestle, you know, to receive that blessing, we're doing the same thing right now. All right, you know, and in this fight, you know, different things are going to have happen to us. All right, we're going to have to face different obstacles, you know, the same way that Jacob's thigh was taken out of joint. You know, we're going to have to, you know, face different things during this fight, you know, but our desire for that blessing, the kingdom, you know, has to outweigh that, right? Outweigh that pain and suffering. So let's continue. It says, verse 58, that if he be overcome, he shall suffer as thou hast said, but if he get the victory, he shall receive the thing that I say. All right, so if we get the victory, you know, if we overcome, we continue to endure, we're gonna get the thing that the Lord said we would get. Right, you know, salvation, everlasting life, right, being placed back in our own land, so on and so forth. All right, the promise that was promised to the 12 tribes of Israel. All right, verse matter of fact, that was pretty much that on that. You know, I want to jump to Proverbs chapter 24. All right, and it says, this is Proverbs chapter 24 and verse 10. And it says, if thou faint in the day of adversity, thy strength is small. All right, you know, so hey, we're not supposed to faint in the day of adversity. You know, during this fight, you know, we're not supposed to faint. We're supposed to continue to, you know, fight and endure. All right, the same way that our forefather Jacob did, you know, even though his thigh was taken out of joint, you know, but if you faint, you know, your strength is small. You know, ultimately, that means you didn't have any faith, you know. So, hey, you know, in this walk, you know, we got to practice, you know, our faith. All right, we got to practice, you know, practice that. You know, we got to make sure that, you know, we're having faith. Verse Salaki, I want to jump to 2 Timothy chapter 2. And let's read verse 3. And it says, thou therefore endure hardness as a good soldier of Yahushua Mashiach. All right. You know, in this fight, you know, we have to endure hardness, right? Because, hey, this walk is not easy. You know, it's extremely hard. That's why it's called the straight and narrow. You know, fire on one side and water on the other, all right? You know, it's a very dangerous path, you know, where you could fall, you know? So, hey, you know, we're supposed to endure hardness as a good soldier, Yahusha Mashiach, all right? You know, despite whatever is thrown our way. So I want to end off with this, Revelation chapter 3. And let's start at verse 10. And it says, because thou hast kept my word, so like I kept the word of my patience, I will also keep thee from the hour of temptation, which shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth. All right. And that's the times that we're living in right now. The hour of temptation is right at the door, and we're all going to be tried. You know, our faith is going to be tried. All right. You know, but we're going to have to continue to fight, continue to endure, you know, to continue to have faith. And the trying times that we're coming into, all right? You know, our faith is going to be tried like it has never been before, all right? Now, verse 11 is the point that I want to get. And it says, behold, I come quickly. Hold that fast which thou hast, that no man take thy crown. All right. So you want to continue to endure, you know, hold on to what you have, you know, your faith, you know, so on and so forth. All right. You know, that no man take your crown. All right. Continue to fight. Continue to endure. All right. You know, like our forefather Jacob did, you know, when he was wrestling, you know, and his thigh was taken out of joint. All right. You know, because in the times that we're coming into, you know, we're going to have to face many different obstacles. All right. You know, but we're going to have to continue to fight, you know, and make sure that our desire for the kingdom, you know, outweighs, you know, or the trouble and the pain that we're going through. All right. So with that, you know, Lord willing, you know, this quick lesson was edifying and exhorting to you brothers and you sisters out there that scattered to the four corners of the earth. And as always, I want to give all praises, honor, and infinite glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Rakakudash, for giving me the spirit to do this lesson. Double honors to the elders and apostles of Great Millstone, and Shalom to you brothers that's out there pushing this truth and sincerity. Shalom.